Goeiedag studenten en baie welkom bij vandaagse lockdown les voor personeel bestuur in 6. In this video we are going to give an overview of module 5 where we're going to talk about using information systems to manage human resources in the business. En ons gaan ook so vinnig kyk na wat is die verskil tussen twee van die hoofkonsepte waaroor hierdie hoofstuk gaan. Now you can follow with me in your textbook on page 78. On page 78 you'll see the talk about computerized information systems, waar ons gaan kyk na die menslike hulpbron inligtingssisteem, as well as the management information system and what the two actually entails. On page 79 there's the objectives of the HRIS, wat ons bereik daarmee en wat die voordele. Then we're going to look at the development of a computerized HRIS, hoe word so 'n systeem ontwikkel, as ook die proses daarvan op bladsy 80. On page 80, we're also going to look at the criteria for evaluating the effectiveness of an HRIS en natuurlijk of een mens dit kan gebruik in die concept van jou besigheid. On page 81, we're going to look at how can we actually use a computerized HRIS within training and HR and compensation and benefits. En ons gaan kyk na talente en prestatiebestuur enzovoorts. And this module will then be ended off on page 82 with how do we present the information obtained from a computerized HRIS. Okay, so hoe kan ons die inligting wat ons gebruik of verkry het van hierdie systeem gebruik tydens die aanbieding van inligting in 'n vergadering of 'n opleidingssessie. Okay. So for the purpose of this video, let's turn back to page 78, dat is 78, en ons gaan nou 'n bietjie kyk na wat is die verskil tussen 'n MIS en 'n HRIS. Okay, what is the difference between these two concepts? The first and foremost thing that you need to understand is what is the difference between data and information? Okay, wat is die verskil tussen data en inligting? They say data is normally unprocessed, so dis jou onverwerkte rou data. So you can pull, for example, information on all your employees from the HRIS, byvoorbeeld hulle ouderdom, hulle geslagte, hulle raste, hulle kwalifikasies, al daai tipe goed. That will be seen as data, want almal se data is daar. But if you want to, for example, get information about how many females between the ages of 30 and 40 has a 3-year degree. Okay, dit is wanneer jy die data vat en jy verwerk dit om inligting daaruit te onttrek. Okay, so in most cases data is raw, it's unprocessed, whereas the information is what we get from data after it has been processed. Technologie maak ons lewe vandag baie baie makliker, as you'll see when you one day join the HR force. Dit maak het regtig baie makliker, baie vinniger and also more accurate. Now what is a MIS? MIS stands for Management Information System. Most organizations have such a system waar elke bestuurder in elke departement gekoppel word aan die bestuurssysteem and all the information relevant to their departments will be captured onto this system. Okay, so as jy in purchasing is, word alles in purchasing op hierdie systeem of jou element van hierdie systeem gekoppel. HRIS, the Human Resource Information System, forms part of the MIS. Okay? So om het meer eenvoudig te stel, jou MIS of bestuursinligtingstelsel is jou groot sambreel, dis jou hele systeem vir die hele besigheid, waar jou HRIS of menslike hulpbron inligtingssisteem is net een deel van hierdie spesifieke sambreel. Okay, and we as HR feed into the HRIS and the HRIS will then feed into the MIS to provide the rest of the business with information on human resources. Okay, nou hulle sê daar aan die onderkant van bladsy 78, a human resource information system can therefore be defined separately as the following. Okay, so is 'n verskillende definisie. Nommer 1, dis 'n software of online oplossing. Een sagteware of online oplossing for the gathering, entry and integration of data. So jy kry nie dit inligting nie, jy integreer dit en jy kan dit ook analiseer. That is built into a human resource database. So dis 'n hele verskillende databasis apart van die ander departemente wat net inligting het oor personeel, hulle salarisse, hulle onderwys en hulle opvoeding ensovoorts. To provide human resources information that can be analyzed and checked by authorized managers. Okay, net gemagtigde personeel kan hierdie spesifieke HRIS systeem toegang tot verkry. Why? Because it's confidential personal information. You cannot just give everyone access to the HRIS because of the type of and the nature of the information that is stored on there. Byvoorbeeld, hulle gee vir jou daar the payroll, how we pay money, your salary, your benefits, your salarisverhoging, your bonus, everything is captured onto the HRIS section of the payroll. Natuurlijk ook die administratie van die voordelen, the cost information, but in andere woorden, wat kost menselijke hulpbronne die bezigheid per jaar? And then of course individual records in terms of their family members, their education, their work experience, the opleiding wat hulle ontvang, hulle prestatie, leave and in terms of annual leave or sick leave. Alles omtrent je werkers wordt op hierdie systeem en vir al die HRIS component daarvan gestoor. Now what is the objectives of such a HRIS? First of all, we want to speed up the provision of accurate data. Het maak het baie makkeliker as die fabriekshoof of die departementshoof jou bel en sê, hoor jy, ek soek gou inligting, hoeveel werkers in ons besigheid het matriek of hoeveel het nie matriek nie. They can go into the system and with the one or two clicks on the button, they will get the information just like that. In die ou dae moes hulle fisies deur elke personeel leer gaan en die inligting gaan onttrek, of hulle moes dit op skriftelike dokumentasie hê, and this can take a long time to process, but with the machine soos hierdie, is vinnig, meer akkuraat. It also reduces the amount of people required to perform routine administration. In die verlede was HR 'n baie administratiewe funksie, and today we hardly ever have HR administrators, omdat jou systeem in 'n mate daardie funksie vervang het. So you might have one or two administrators, but you might not have a team of them in general. Natuurlijk gee dit ook die geleentheid vir opgeleide HR personeel om regtig te fokus op dit wat belangrik is vir menslike hulpbronne. HR has become a more strategic business partner, waar ons nie meer net gaan administratie doen nie, but we're going to really add value in terms of increasing productivity, addressing performance gaps, and increasing performance of our employees in general. Okay, dit is jou drie hoof doelwitte daarvan. If you look at the examples, it saves time, like I've already mentioned, it spaar regtig baie tyd, spaar baie papier, en daarom spaar ons die bome. Okay, we don't want to print a lot of documentation. It reduces routine administration, het maak het net bietjie vinniger en makkeliker. It improves communication drastically because everything is available at the click of a button. It helps to improve decision making en natuurlijk laastens verhoog het ook productiviteit vooral binnenin jou HR departemente. Okay, so dit is die inleiding tot hoofstuk 5. In the next video we will look at the development of a computerized HRIS. En tot dan, bye!